Right, in today's video, I want to cover the stock geometry and how to set that up in the new version 11 lathe software that Hurco recently released. It's a little bit different than the previous version of the lathe software. It's a little easier to use, and I want to show what some of the different settings are and a couple of the different circumstances when you may use different settings. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to create in this program, I'm just going to put a position block in just so when I hit draw, something will draw. And I'm going to go to the part setup and put a value of 11 inches in there. Before we draw anything or do any programming in the lathe software, we have to put a placeholder or something in our part setup. I usually use 11 inches, and we'll play around with that, changing those numbers here in a little while so you can see how that behaves. Once I'm on the part setup screen and I have entered in Z offset, I'm going to go down and hit the stock geometry tab. And that takes me to the screen where I'm going to set up the stock geometry I'm going to use. Manually stock length, using manual stock length, I'm going to leave that at no. I want to have it automatically put that in. I'm going to tell it that it's a 4-inch diameter piece of stock with a 3-inch through hole, so a piece of tubing. Make sure that the correct work offset is active. In this case, it's going to be offset 1, which is 11 inches. And I want to be referencing part 0. The Z reference position, at this point, we're going to leave 0. I'll show you how that works here in a minute. If I go to my graphics screen now and I hit draw, I'm going to get a piece of stock that is 11 inches long, because that's what our part setup is, and the very front edge of that part is going to be 0. If I go into my settings here, I can turn on the stock or the chuck and jaws, and you can see that the 11 inches is actually measured from the face of the spindle or the back mounting surface of the chuck out to the end of the part. That's what that 11 inches actually represents. I'm going to go back up to my settings here, and I'm going to turn off the stock or the chuck and jaws just for clarity. Go ahead and turn that back off. So in this case, and it's what we're going to do with about 90% of the time, you're going to always just have your stock setup be whatever the length is, and we're going to add a little bit to the front to remove some material when I face it off. Right now, if I went in and I face the block or the face the material off the front of this part, it's going to be not showing anything because Z0 is the face of this particular piece of stock. There's nothing to remove. The machine will work just fine, graphics will run just fine, I just won't get any visual reference that it was machined off. So the way we do that is we're going to put a value in here in the reference position. I'm going to put a quarter of an inch just because I want it to be very visible on screen, but typically you would put in 25 thousandths, 30 thousandths, whatever you would typically face off the front of that part. And what it's going to do is going to extend that 11 inches by whatever you put that in there. So you can see that Z0 now is inside the part or the stock by a quarter of an inch. So now when I would program something, it would come down and actually show it removing that. Again, just giving me a little bit more realistic view in my graphics. When it's time to actually go set up the machine, I don't have to change anything. Obviously, I've put 11 inches in there as some erroneous number that just is going to be used for me programming. But when I go do my part setup on the machine, I'm actually going to get some actual value in there. I'm going to put 8.75. Let's say that when I touch off, that's what the value is. Go back to my stock geometry. Now we see that that work offset number has changed here. And when I hit draw, it's going to shorten that material up to then being 8 inches 750 plus that quarter inch on the end. So it'd be 9 inch piece of material. So that's how we would use the graphics and the stock geometry most of the time. There will be times, however, that we want to manually size the stock. If that is something that you need to do, then we're going to say yes, we want to manually size it. It's going to then bring in a new field called stock length. So we put in whatever length of stock we want to use. I'm going to leave 4 inches because it'll be good for just visual representation. We still want to reference part 0 or the 0 on the part. And for now, I'm going to zero this reference position out. When I hit draw, you can see that the face of the part is still 0, but our stock is only 4 inches. Even though we're referencing the face of the spindle or the back of the chuck, from back here somewhere, it still just shows the 4-inch piece of material that I asked for. If I wanted to face any extra material off here, I'm going to put 2 inches in, which is half the length of this particular piece of stock, just to show you that it doesn't behave exactly like the other. It just literally moves the stock that 2 inches positive, so zero is now in the middle of the stock. What this is most useful for is, if I would put the full 4 inches, it's for when I want to program from the backside of the piece of material. If I wanted to call this zero, make all my Z's positive in the program, then this is what I would want to do. I'd go in and say, yes, I want to manually size my stock. I want to give it the actual length of the part, and then shift that part by the amount that I need to. If I were going to leave extra stock to machine off on this one, I'll use that 1/4 inch that we used here a second ago, then I would actually add that to the length of stock, and it would then increase the stock length by 4 1/4, or by 1/4 inch, but then I would have to show that same extra 1/4 inch in my reference position, because you see here, when I moved it 4 inches, it left this hanging here. I want that on the front side, so I would add that to both the reference position as well as the stock length. A couple other things that are pretty neat about the new software here is, in addition to being able to go from opaque or transparent, where I can see through this part a little bit, I can also, under settings, click the section view, full view, 3/4 view. Sorry. Or half view. So now I can determine how much of the material that I want to see. I can turn on and off things like the stock outline. Again, make it transparent or opaque. So a lot of new settings that have come in with the new version 11 software that'll be pretty handy, as well as a much easier user interface when it comes to stock geometry, when we're setting up for either programming from the front of the part back, or from the back being zero and programming forward.